Let us start with this analysis of determinate structures, which we have to study during the current semester as the first topic of analysis of structures. Here, first let us go through each and every terminology of these particular wordings. One is what is meant by analysis. Next, what is determinate structure or just determinacy of the structure. Then what is civil engineering structure which you are analyzing. Each of these three terminologies, let us try to understand first one by one. First, let us take this structure, that is civil engineering structures, particularly with reference to civil engineering structures. These civil engineering structures which we come across in day-to-day practice, we can broadly classify them into two categories. One is discrete structure. Okay. Then second one is continuum structure. Broadly you can classify any civil engineering structure under these two categories, discrete structure, continuum structure, depending upon its shape or depending upon its composition. Any structure it is made out of number of smaller elements or members. So depending upon the shape of the member, you can classify that broadly. Looking at the geometry of the structure of the body, you can just classify them into two categories. Here, discrete structure means it is made out of one-dimensional elements, or it is also called as line elements. Line is a one-dimensional element. So these discrete structures are made out of or built out of these one-dimensional or line type of elements, like this, having two ends, line type of structure. Structure made out of line elements, or like this, a structure like this. It is called truss structure. It is made out of only one-dimensional elements, or it may be a structure like this. It is also made out of only line elements, and each of these line elements are interconnected at the ends either by pin joints or rigid joint. This sort of structure we call it as discrete structure. Either it may be linear in profile, or the axis of that particular line element may be linear, or it may be curved also, like this. The axis of that particular line, it may be curved in shape or it may be linear. If it is curved, we call it as arch, or if it is like this supported, it is called as the cable. All these sort of structures which are made out of by one dimensional elements or line elements, we call it as discrete type of civil engineering structure. And here continuum structure means it is made out of by other two and three dimensional elements. Two dimensional element means it is area elements, like triangles, number of triangles, or that is you can discretize the structure into small pieces which are two dimensional areas. That is, two dimensions are important when compared to third dimension, like triangles, rectangle, quadrilateral or square. So it is made out of two or three dimensional elements. So like a slab structure, like that. If you have a two dimensional structure, this you can just ADLS has made out of number of quadrilaterals or rectangles like that, number of elements which are interconnected at the ends by some points which we call it as the nodal points or joints of the structure. This sort of structure we call it as the continuum. Here again, the boundary is either it may be straight or it may be curved in shape, like that, that also. So here also you can idealize that either in the form of two-dimensional elements like triangles, quadrilaterals, rectangles, as I have shown here, rectangles, or it may be square, like that. If it is two-dimensional, made out of two-dimensional elements, or if it is three-dimensional elements, then it may be made out of by tetrahedrons or hexahedron, or it may be a brick type of element. There are three-dimensional elements. Suppose if you have a solid element like that, three-dimensional one, see, it is made out of bricks like that. Each is a brick quantity, or it may be a tetrahedron shape. It is made out of by tetrahedron shape. So like that, such structures which are made out of small elements which are either two-dimensional one or three-dimensional one, we call it as a continuum type of structure. So broadly, any structure which you see in day-to-day practice as civil engineering structure, you can classify them as discrete variety or open type of structure made out of by line elements, or continuum structure made out of by area elements, either triangle, quadrilateral, rectangle, square, or three-dimensional element like made out of by tetrahedrons or hexahedrons or this brick type of element. That is the broad category of the civil engineering structure. Any structure, it will fall under this particular category. So here in your curriculum, you are going to study only discrete type of structures. Continuum type of structures, you are not going to study here in this particular course. Only discrete type of structures, which are basically made out of by one-dimensional members or elements, only we are considering in this particular course. Further, these discrete structures, you can further classify them as planar structures or space structures. That is, planar discrete structures or space type of discrete structure. You can subclassify them, this type of discrete structure. Planar structures means, I told you, all these smaller one-dimensional elements, they are all like in one plane, like this. In all these examples which I have written, shown here, they are all like in one plane. That type of structures, this either it may be a simple beam, or it may be a continuous beam, or it may be a truss, rigid plane frame, or arch, or cable. In all these, which are made out of by only line elements, all elements like in one plane, they are called planar structures. Or if all these elements lie in different planes, like this, all these one-dimensional elements, they lie in different planes, then it is called space structure. Right? Here again, we are dealing with only analysis of plane structures only and not space structure. So we are dealing with the analysis of civil engineering discrete planar structures. That is, first you have to understand what is meant by analysis of structure. What is that structure you are analyzing? that is only planar type of discrete civil engineering structure. Each and every terminology, the moment a shape is given, a structure is given, which is a body object is given, you should identify that what type of structure it is, whether it is a discrete type or continuum type of structure, whether it is a truss type of structure or a beam type of structure or a rigid frame type of structure. That are called different forms of structure that you have to identify. Here broadly I have defined one dimensional discrete structure, here planar structure, here again is planar structure. You can further classify them as in-jointed type of planar structure or rigid jointed type of planar structure. This is the broad classification of this discrete structure which you are going to study. Here in-jointed type of structure means it's a plane structure wherein all elements are interconnected by pin joint, that is this sort of structure wherein each element is at the ends, it is going to be interconnected by a pin. That type of structure we call it as truss. Basically if the joints are pin, then that type of planar structure we call it as truss. If it is not pin jointed, if it is rigidly jointed, if all the elements they are rigidly connected here at the end, they are called rigid jointed type of structure. Beam also here, this member, they are rigidly connected, whereas here it is pin jointed. Here also it is simply support of free joint. Here it is either hinge or fixed. So either it may be pin jointed or rigid jointed beams. Generally at mid joints it will be rigid, at the end either it may be rigid or fixed. So accordingly but here in beam and frames we don't call it as a truss. If all the joints are pin joint, then that type of planar structure, planar discrete structure, we call it as a truss. And if all the elements lie in one plane, it is plane truss. If all the elements lie in different planes, like this in space structure also, you can classify similarly as pin joint type and rigid joint. Accordingly, it is called as pin jointed space truss or rigid space frame. Here it is rigid plane frame, here plane truss. So generally pin jointed frame structures or one dimensional structure we call it as trusses. If it is in one plane, plane truss. If they are in different planes, space truss. Similarly, if all members are rigidly connected and if it is rigid joint, if all are lying in one plane, it is called as either a beam truss or a beam or rigid plane frame. If all members lie in different plane, it is called as space type of structure. This is the broad classification of structure, what you have. So during the current topic or current course, you are going to study pin jointed, rigid jointed, planar type of discrete structure. That means you are analyzing the beams as well as trusses, archers and cables. So you know now what are the type of structure you are going to study during the current semester, type of structure. Here I title is analysis of determined structure. What is that structure you are studying that I have explained in this particular discussion. So this first you have to remember what type of structure you are going to analyze during the current coursework. That is only beams, this sort of structure we call it as beam, this only single span we call it as beam or simple beam. Here it is called as cantilever wherein only one side is fixed. Here only one span is there, it is called as beam. Here more than one span, we call it as continuous beam. Here it is called as plane truss. Here it is called rigid plane frame. So you are going to just analyze cantilevers, beams, and some continuous beams. Of course, continuous beam becomes indeterminate structure. Here, because you have one more word called determinate, so that we will take up a little bit later what is determinacy means. Only now I am explaining what is structure. Next, we will take up determinacy. If we study determinacy, then again, this is further classified into determinate type of structure, indeterminate type of structure. So you are going to study in the current course only determinate type of structure. Then next we will take up the third term, what is analysis? What do you mean by analysis? What is that you are supposed to do in the analysis of these varieties of problem when they are put into use or when they are subjected to some kind of loading? That is the actual subject matter in the nutshell. You have to understand what is structure, you have to understand what is determinacy, you have to understand what is analysis. All these three put together, if you just, is called one unit in your syllabus, and that you should know first, or that you should be well versed before going for the further units. That is the actual analysis. What are the things you have to do? And different varieties of structures, arches, cables, and when they are subject, what type of loadings, whether it is static load or moving load, all these are going to be dealt in different topics. Right? So this first aspect, you should know what is type of structure which you are analyzing. That is, basically you are analyzing determinate type of beams, determinate type of plane truss, determinate type of rigid plane frame. That's all. So virtually you can just take out about 5 or 6 type of problems only. Cantilever subjected to different loading, simple beam subjected to different loading, and plane truss subjected to different loading. Then they will just, they are all determinate type of structures. For that only you are analyzing. Hardly, maybe maximum about a dozen type of problem you are going to study one by one in the analysis. Next, we will take up what is this analysis part. Having understood what is structure, what are the type of structures you are going to study, that I have given here as a note. So there are 2 types of structures, broadly, discrete, continuous. Discrete means it is made out of only line elements or line members. Continuum means made out of 2-dimensional area elements or 3-dimensional volume elements. Either volume elements, area elements. If it is made out of the structure, you can just divide that into small elements or pieces which are either 2-dimensional areas or 3-dimensional volume. Such structure we call it as continuum. If you idealize a structure which are only by line elements, which are interconnected either by thin or rigid joint, and all lie in one plane or different plane, that we call it as a discrete type of structure. That you should know the definition. What is the type of form of elements or members of the structure, and what is its composition, what is its shape? All those, if you know, if you identify, then you can do that analysis. Next, we will take up what is meant by analysis of a structure. So, analysis of a structure involves always determination of, analysis involves determination of support external support reactions, then all internal member end forces, member end forces or element end forces, because here I told you each structure is made out of by number of elements, and that number of elements, either it may be light type of element or area type of element or volume type of element, which have end points which are going to be connected to other elements only at finite number of points, which we call it as joints or nodes. So you are going to determine the end forces only at those nodal points or joints of that particular structure. Unknowns we determine, the member unknowns we are going to determine, member forces which we call internal member forces, that you are determining only at the joints or nodal points, that you have to determine. And third one, you have to find out the displacement at joints or ends or nodes. So type of the displacement. So these are the three things which you have to evaluate during analysis. Analysis of structure means each structure is put into use to take some kind of load. Because of that load, some kind of work is being done. Load is a type of force. Because of that force, some kind of deformation should be there. Because work has to be done. Whenever there is a load or force, work has to be done. And that work is measured by load multiplied by the displacement. That means deformation is bound to occur. So that deformation you have to estimate. Because of that deformation, to resist the response of the structure will be by the development of internal member forces. That internal member forces will be infinite number of points in the members. All those points we don't consider, only salient points, that's preferably the end points, the joint location, that only we consider, and at those points only we evaluate what is the resistance or response due to the load, which we call it as the internal force, that you have to get it. Here deformation, that this is internal force developed or resistance which is going to develop on account of, because you know from Newton's third law, for every action there will be equal and opposite reaction, so that structure will be in stable condition or equilibrium condition. If it should not yield on account of the load, it should be in same equilibrium condition, or it should not move at all, so that there should not be any net force acting on the structure. And we have to apply that particular condition for evaluating these internal member forces. And we have to determine deformation. These two are a must, that is response of the structure on account of the load. Then generally all structures, whatever it is going to take up load, it will be having supports to the end. Ultimately all this load has to be taken ultimately down below, that is to the ground. And that ground point where it is going to be supported, and that type of support, what is the net reaction which is going to be developed at the support, that also we have to determine, because that dumps analysis also is a separate one. Foundation analysis, there we should have the knowledge about the support reaction, that also you have to determine during the analysis. So all these three major quantities you have to determine during analysis. Analysis means after knowing given a structure, given a particular type of action or load, due to that load, some kind of resistance or will be there in the structure in the form of deformation as well as internal member forces, that we have to evaluate. And also each structure will have a support, that reaction at the end support, that also you have to estimate. So these are the three things which you have to evaluate or determine during analysis. This part you have to remember. One, type of structure, then what is analysis of structure? And here, type of supports, already I think you have studied this in your applied mechanics. So generally, we are dealing with only planar structures. For these planar structures, and planar discrete structures only we are telling, I told you that you should not forget, only we are dealing with planar type of thin and rigid jointed type of discrete structures. And these structures will be provided with three types of external support, three types of external supports at the ends. At the ends of each of these members, there will be three types of supports. Generally, you can provide. One is called simple or roller type of support. Roller type of support. Then second, hinge type of support. Then you have fixed type of support. These are the type of support which we normally provide. So here already I have shown here. So this sort of support we call it as simple support or prop support. Or is also represented in the form of roller like that. This roller type of support or simple support, they are similar in nature. Then you have what is known as hinge type of support. Here this structure, planar discrete structure, has shown hinge type of support as well as roller type of support. Then you have what is known as fixed type of support. This is the notation which we use for showing the fixed type of support. So that is another type of support which we provide for that planar discrete structure. Because I told you we are dealing with only discrete structures and that too planar structures only. These planar discrete type of structures are provided with this type of support, and here these type of support they are represented at the ends in this notation. So this is called simple support, roller support, and this sort of support it is called hinge type of support, and this sort of support we call it as fixed type of support. This is the notation we use. So the speciality of this type of support which you have already know, and this type of support, so this particular point or joint or end of the element is not allowed to move in the vertical direction. So here this is not allowed to move in the vertical direction. Here also it is not allowed to move in the vertical direction. So because generally they are all called planar structures, since planar structures we are called and dealing with, so in the planar type of structure, any type of displacement which we occur, because I told you we will get displacement on account of the load, and then because of the displacement, internal forces will be there, then support reactions will develop. We are dealing with the support reactions now. Here, any type of planar structures which will undergo displacement in the plane. So displacement has to occur in the given plane. All these members lay in this vertical plane, that's the plane of the board. All these structures, they are all lying in plane of board. So you will get displacement in the plane, within the plane, only in any direction. Out of plane displacements, we are not considering. The loads has to result in the in-plane displacement. That in-plane displacement in any direction which occur, you can always resolve them into two, three fundamental direction or two fundamental direction. That is horizontal direction and vertical direction. The third direction, which is out of plane, we are not considering. In-plane displacement which occur in any direction, you can resolve that only into two orthogonal directions. One is horizontal, another vertical for analysis purpose. So the displacement at any point or any end of the structure or any end of the element will be only two types. One is horizontal, another vertical. That is translated type of displacement I am talking about. There are two types of displacement which occur. One is translated type of displacement, that is linear type of displacement. Another, rotatory type of displacement or angular type of displacement. Two types of displacement which you are going to get. These two displacement you can always resolve into these coordinate axis direction. The translated displacement you can resolve into two directions. The angular type of displacement we will just see. The angular type of displacement along this horizontal axis will be like this. So that is out of plane only, which we have not considered. The angular type of displacement will be about vertical axis. It has to be like this. About the vertical axis, angular type of displacement is like this. That's again out of plane. Out of plane of the boat, that also we don't consider. Another type axis is there, that is axis normal to the plane. So the rotation about that will be within the plane itself. That is the rotatory type of displacement we consider. So generally, in this planar structural point, we can have two types of linear displacement and another type of angular displacement about the axis normal to the plane in which that particular structure lies. So three types of displacement is possible. This you should bear it in mind. I am talking about this point, types of displacements which we have to determine. So three types of displacements only possible. Displacement can occur in any direction. So all these displacements which occur in any direction in a given plane, you can resolve into three fundamental directions, horizontal, vertical and that, for analysis purpose. For analysis purpose, you have already done resolution of forces in your, or the number of forces acting at a particular point. You, during the analysis, you will find out only you are replacing all of them by a single force, by resolving all those forces into two fundamental directions or planar forces. If they are all non-coplanar forces, then you are doing, it's a space work, you are dissolving them into all the three directions. Here, it is only two translators, another only one rotation, that is about the axis. Three types of displacements which you have to find out during the analysis of the plane, frame, discrete structures. So here, the type of support what we are considering, at any joint, out of these three possible displacement, the horizontal displacement and rotation, both are allowed to occur. So here, at simple support, it is allowed to occur rotation. Right? It is allowed to move horizontally, here also. But not allowed to move in the vertical direction. When that movement is restricted, there must be a force, inherent force, which you have to remember, which is holding that in that position. So that inherent force, we call it as the reaction. So at simple support or roller support, there will be a vertical type of reaction that you have to remember. Then here, hinge type of support. So in this type of support, both these displacements are restricted. That is, this point and this, it is not allowed to move horizontally, not allowed to move vertically, but allowed to rotate at hinge. So since two displacements are restricted, there will be two reactions which is holding that. Two reactions will be there. In a fixed type of support, all these three displacements are not allowed to occur at all. Neither it is that particular point is allowed to move horizontally, nor allowed to move vertically, nor allowed to rotate. So all the three are restricted. That means there must be inherent, three inherent forces, that is horizontal force, vertical force, vertical reaction, and moment. These are the external support reactions. So these reactions you have to determine during analysis. So these are all very important basic concepts which you have to remember. Keep on listening to this again when you are just looking into the video, and just have it in mind, because each and every point what I am telling is very, very important thing. Go on just looking into the video 2-3 times, replay it, understand it thoroughly. Everything I have defined, what is structure, discrete structure only we are considering, what is the discrete structure I have defined, what all the type of structures, discrete structures we come across, that also I have told, only the type of problem, either linear profile or curved profile also, and how are that members will lie, whether it is in plane or in all the planes, or how they are, each elements are interconnected, whether thin joint, rigid joint, what are the types of supports at the ends, ultimately these structures will be provided, and what are the types of supports, and what are the reactions which are there at the support. So these both I have told here. During analysis, what we are doing, external support reactions, after knowing the type of support, and displacements at the joint, what are the type of displacement? Generally, you have only 3 types of displacement. That's only because planar structure only we are considering, that you have to remember. In the planar structure, generally, we have 3 coordinate axes. With reference to 3 coordinates, only we determine this displacement. And there will be 2 types of displacement, linear, angular. So 3 axes will be there, x, y, z coordinate axis. 3 displacements means 3 translatory type, 3 rotatory type. Totally in general, 6 types of displacement. Out of these 6, here the 3rd linear displacement is not possible because out of plane, and 2 rotations about x and y, there also out of plane it is not there. Only 3 are possible. Out of the 3 displacement, especially at the support, some are only possible, some are not possible. Here, vertical is not possible in roller or simple. Here, only rotation is possible. Here, and all the 3 are not possible. So, there must be a force, and that we call it as a reaction at the support. Knowing those ideas, looking at the type of support, using that notation, you have to mark the reaction, that you have to determine during analysis. Next, displacements, you have to mark again, 3 types of displacement. At each joint, you have to mark 3 types of displacement, which are the displacements which are possible, that only you have to determine. Because some only are possible, some may not be possible, as in the case of support. Here also, you have some are possible, some are not possible, that only you have to mark it, and that you have to determine. You have to mark, find out how many, what are the type, number of displacements. That's called kinematic indeterminacy. Number of unknown displacements which you have to determine during analysis. Then coming to the internal member forces, that is static indeterminacy, that comes, gives a clue about this terminology which I told, determinacy of the structure. Or what is meant by determinacy of the structure? That means, for analyzing the structure, I told you, structure has to be in equilibrium condition or stationary condition. Otherwise, if it is moving, on account of the load, there must be displacement, angular or translation. If it moves visibly, then it is not stable, it is yielding. So that movement has to be zero. That movement has to be zero means net displacement has to be zero, or when displacement is zero, net force also has to be zero. When the net force at all the joints has to be zero, that is called equilibrium condition. That also you have already studied in our applied mechanics. At each joint, we are applying these conditions, right? That is, the unknowns we are selecting only at the ends of the members. At the ends of the elements means at the joints. Ends are nothing but joints. At joints only we apply this equilibrium condition. That is, at each joint, the net force has to be zero because there should not be any displacement. It has to be in stationary condition. There should not be any displacement means there should not be any force. That net force should be zero, that is, net resultant force or has to be zero means it resolved component along x, y, and this rotation moment about z direction has to be zero. That means sigma fx has to be zero, sigma fy has to be zero, sigma mz has to be zero. That condition, three conditions which we are applying at each joint has to be satisfied. That's called equilibrium condition. Satisfying those conditions, we are determining these internal member forces. That's another very, very important aspect of fundamental basic concept which you have to remember. That is, what is the condition you have to apply before the analysis? That is equilibrium condition. That is, total structure has to be in a stationary, that means net force has to be zero. Net force acting on the structure zero means net force at each joint has to be zero. That is, that's the point where each member will be. Net force at each joint has to be zero. That means net resolved component of that net force at each joint has to be zero. That resolved component for this plane or discrete structure is Fx, Fy, Mz, that has to be zero. That is the equilibrium condition. Then boundary condition, I told already, you have to observe the supports. That support condition, reaction, which you have to determine, that's already done. Another one more condition which you have to satisfy is known as compatibility condition. So compatibility condition means at each joint you have number of members meeting the each member, and that end will have certain displacement, and that displacement, whatever you are going to get, that can again be resolved into this fundamental direction. That resolved component into fundamental direction at the end of each member has to be same. The wording is very, very important. Anyway, that we will supply you in the form of notes. Equilibrium condition, compatibility condition, boundary condition, all these which I have told. So you better, if you prepare notes on your own, then listening to this two, three times I told, better write it. What is frame structure? What is conjointed structure? What is plane frame? What are type of supports? What is the alignment by analysis? What are the internal forces which you have to determine? What are the displacements which you have to determine? What are the conditions which you will apply for determining these quantities? That's equilibrium condition, which already I told. Then boundary condition, that is at the end, mainly at the supports, boundary condition. Then compatibility condition also, just now I stated, compatibility condition involves the component of displacement at the end of all members at any joint has to be same. The component of displacement. Suppose if you take this member, the component x component of this displacement of this member is say some u. Then if you take this member, the x component of horizontal displacement of that member, so they have to be same, and that will be equal to the joint displacement. That is that compatibility condition. So many things I have told. I have defined what is structure, then I have defined what is analysis of structure, then of course determinacy, still I have not yet completed, only the conditions for determining the determinacy I have told, that the condition is equilibrium condition, compatibility, boundary condition, that you have to apply, and then you have to decide whether structure is determinate or indeterminate, because these conditions, equilibrium, compatibility, we apply only at the joints of the structure, that you have to remember, joints of the structure. Joints means it is the point wherein member, where more than one members are meeting. Members has two ends, each any member, so the end one, therein, it is connected with other members or other elements, we call it the joint. And we treat all the unknowns only at those joints, and we apply this condition only at the joints, and along with the boundary conditions also, the support conditions. So this much conditions which you have to remember, these are all the equilibrium, compatibility, and then how many conditions we have means generally for finding the support, we have three equilibrium conditions, sum of all horizontal forces zero, sum of all vertical forces zero, sum of moment about the axis, that axis normal to the plane is zero. By applying these three equilibrium equations, if you find out if R is the number of support reactions, here one hinge, one roller, that means here you have two reactions, here one reaction, totally R will be 3. R is called total number of support reactions for the structure. Here you have 3 reactions, here 3, so for this you have 6 as the value of R. So that R is the number of support reactions, and 3 is the equations of equilibrium available for finding these reactions, that is sum of horizontal forces acting on the structure should be 0, sum of vertical forces acting on the structure 0, sum of moment about any support is 0. So if you apply these 3 equations, so if you are able to determine all the reactions R, then it is called determinate. If you cannot determine, it is called indeterminate. So that is with respect to, that's called the external indeterminacy. We define that indeterminacy with respect to support reaction, that is external indeterminacy. So in all these fields, it is externally indeterminate only. So it is just enough if you use this formula and determine that. So that is also determinacy also I told. So only analysis of determinate structure, the 3 terms only I have explained now. What is structure? What is analysis? What is determinacy? So this complete 1 hour roughly, I have just taken only these 3 terminologies. So this is what we have to determine. All these points, whatever I have told, that we have to determine. That's all the analysis. So given your structure, so identify the structure, then what all the things you have to determine during analysis, that you list, then satisfy that condition, equilibrium or whatever it is, then evaluate. That is the analysis of structure, basic philosophy of analysis of determinate. Determinate I have told by applying the equilibrium conditions. So if you are able to solve all these internal forces, support reactions, we call that a determinate structure. So all these three have determined. Otherwise it is called indeterminate, which is of course subject matter of course for in the next semester. Now here is only determinate structure. So from next class onwards, we can go on taking up these structures like trusses, then beams, go on evaluating the quantities. Trusses, we have to analyze support reactions, internal member forces, then beams, we have to determine the displacement, and internal forces already you have done inverse strength of materials, bending moment, shear force. You have drawn that. So that is internal member forces already you have done. So that you should only other part, displacement we are determining, they are the subject matter in your next units. Second unit, you are determining the displacements by conjugate field method, area moment method. In unit 3, strain energy method you will apply. Unit 4, you will apply analyze arches and cables, then moving loads, again the structures you analyze. In this unit 1 of 4, stress analysis only, you do it, that we will take up in the next.